It's like about 20. So, I think it's kind of a special number because, if you think about it, see, you've got a polygon. And like this. One. It has, one, two, three vertices here. And now I'm going to have 20 divided by 3 rounded down. This is equal to 6. But hang on a second. Let me figure out a point. Oh, I made a mistake earlier when I did it, I realized. It should be 18, not 20. 18 doesn't, and 20 only works at the beginning, I just realized, so.
So 18 is the magic number.
No,
maybe you should write a little bit larger numbers because this is so tiny for the video.
18 divided by 4, rounded down, is equal to 4. And property holds again. If we do it for 5, then we get 3 out. And yes, that's how many pentagons fit around point. Pentagons are hard to draw.
So you divide it by the number that represents how many sides a polygon has.
Five.
And when you do the division, the result is how many of those polygons fit around a point.
If we do 6, we can do 6, of course. We'll also get 3. Hey, but that's how many hexagons fit around a point.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
And yes, we have 3 hexagons fitting around a point. Heptagons! 18 divided by 7, round down. Is equal to 2. That's how many heptagons fit around a point, of course. If we do 18 divided by 8, round it down, it's also going to give us 2. 18 divided by 9 is also equal to 2. Only at 10 is going to fail. It's 1, but 2. 2 decagons can fit around a point, of course. So, only here it fails.
Because starting from heptagons, it's always no more than 2? Polygons can fit around the point?
Starting from decagons, it's... Yeah. 19 also has that property. So, up to 9 it works, but 10 again doesn't work.
And how did you discover this?
But actually, no other number. So 20 works, but it already fails here, so,
How did you discover this, Simon?
But 20, also works, but already fails here, so, and so 18 stops at 9, right?
Yeah.
It fails at 10 here. Fails at 10. So, 9 is the last one that works. 19 also has the property. 9 is the last one that works. For 20, the last one that works is the... The last one that works is the first one that works. This one. And actually, no more numbers actually work at the beginning at all. So...
So 18 is unique.
18, 19, and 20. Yeah.
Yeah, but 20 doesn't work in the beginning.
It does work in the beginning. It doesn't work in the second one.
Yeah, well, that's also the starting phase. But how did you come up with this?
How did I come up with this? Well, I was watching a video where it's kind of like talked related to that. It has to do with tiling or that sort of stuff. But yeah, I just realized it, and so yeah. But that means that there's something special about the number 9, right? The number 9 seems to be a maximum for when it stops. So 20, the last one that works is just the last one that works is for triangles. For 18 and 19, the last one works for is not a count. And no more numbers actually work at the beginning. So.
What's that? Is that a zero?
So. No more numbers actually work at the beginning. So. 18, 19, and 20 are special numbers, but I don't know why. So
you discovered something, but you don't know why this is so.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't know why the scheme looks like this. Another interesting thing that I discovered is the number of polygons that fit around a point is always a factor of 12. Another arbitrary number pops up. Okay, so... Right? 6?
Yeah.
Fit around point, 4 fit around point, 3 fit around point, 3 fit around point, and then 2, 2, 2.
Maybe it's just because 12 is a highly divisible number.
Highly composite.
Composite, sorry.
Highly composite. Maybe. But, yeah. Highly composite, but it has no fact, at least no proper factors, that are more than 6, so, yeah, it's still kind of special. 12 is kind of used a lot, so I'm not really surprised by that fact, but, yeah, those numbers, 9, 12, 18, 19, 20. Really special numbers.